I think I'm okay with this. Please welcome the adorable Paris Hilton, everybody.
You too.
And welcome. You look lovely. Look at you with your lovely dress, and you've got a little bit of bling there on.
A little bling bling.
Yeah, what is that? What does BH stand for?
It's BM, my boyfriend's initials.
Oh, that's adorable.
And he wears mine.
He wears your initials?
Yeah.
What about a tattoo?
He has a lot of those, but I don't.
Well, you could get one that your initials kind of fitted in and some of his tattoos there. Get something put in. You want to get onto that.
I don't have any, but he could do one of me.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He could do one of you. If he loved you, he would get a tattoo of you on.
He will.
Yeah, I think he will. Would you ever get a tattoo?
No, I'm too scared.
Really? It doesn't hurt.
You have any?
Yeah, I have one, yeah. Yeah, on my arm.
That's hot.
Yeah? Well, I have another one, but I don't talk about it, all right?
Nice. Yeah.
Hey, this musical looks sensational.
Thank you.
You've got black hair in it.
Yeah, I looked pretty different. Every scene, my character's addicted to plastic surgery, so she always looks different.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Yeah. Would
you ever think about ever getting plastic?
Scared.
Well, it's not as bad as getting a tattoo.
I think it is. I'm very happy with the way I look, so.
Yes, you look absolutely lovely. You do. What I wanted to ask you was, your name is Paris, as I'm sure you know. I wonder, do you spend much time in Paris? It's one of my favorite cities in the world, Paris. Do you spend any time there?
Yeah, I go there like 6 times a year.
You do not? Mm-hmm. Where do you go?
I just go for Fashion Week.
Oh, I never go
shopping.
For that. Do you watch Project Runway? Oh, what's wrong with you? That's the greatest show on TV. Project Runway is awesome. You'd love it. If you like Fashion Week, you'd love Project Runway.
I'll check it out.
All right, good. Now, what about the... where'd you go in Paris? You go to Fashion Week. Do you go any around Paris? I like to go to the Luxembourg Gardens. Do you ever go there?
Mm-mm.
Oh, it's nice. They got the... you get a boat. You can rent a little boat and sail it out on the little pond there.
Sounds fun.
It's all right. Well, what do you do for fun, then, if you don't sail boats?
When I go to Paris, I love going to Champs-Élysées and shopping and going to the Louvre.
Do you speak French?
Petit.
Oh, right.
Little.
I'm sorry, I don't understand your French ways. Now, what do you do for recreation, then? If you're not, because you're a very social person, and you seem to be, go to a lot of parties and events and stuff like that. Do you never just, like, you know, put on your pajamas and watch television?
I do.
All right, good.
I watch you sometimes.
You do not?
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, nah, you don't.
I do.
Nah, you
do.
Really?
Yes.
Really, do you?
Yes.
Did I ever say anything mean about you? I do not.
Yeah.
Well, let me just put that right now. I'm really sorry. I'm very terribly sorry.
Well, now that I've came on, maybe you won't do that anymore.
I won't. I absolutely won't. I can't believe I've done it before. It's an extreme lapse of judgment. It doesn't really seem to...
It's all good.
What about the election? You, of course, featured rather largely in this election. The, John McCain saying that he actually thought you might run the country better than Barack Obama at one point. Do you think you could?
No one can do it better than Obama.
Oh,
he's
really?
Amazing.
Well, to be fair... he hasn't started yet, so he can screw it up.
Great.
He could screw it up.
I was a little disappointed my name wasn't on the ballot, though. I went to go vote yesterday, I didn't see my name, and I was kind of upset.
Don't you have to pay to put your name on the ballot?
I don't know.
Do you have to pay? I think you at least have to fill in a form.
But, yeah, I was very excited for that. I think it's history. It's amazing.
It is. It's a very historic election. You voted in California?
Yes. Yesterday.
I thought you were from New York.
No, L.A.
Oh, really? Did you grow up here?
Yeah.
Really?
I went to high school in New York.
Oh, which high school?
Dwight.
Oh, yeah. What about... So, do you surf and everything, then? Do you do all the...
Yeah.
Oh, you do?
Mm-hmm.
You do not? Do you surf?
I love surfing.
Really?
Yeah.
Where do you go? Do you surf with Matthew McConaughey?
No.
I th- think that that's I never knew this about you. So you go surfing. Now, when the paparazzi follow you around, do they follow you to the beach for the surfing?
Yes.
How do they know you're there?
Because they wait outside my house and follow me everywhere.
Do they really?
They're like stalkers.
Why don't you invite them in? Invite them into the house. They'll get used to you, and they'll just kind of, they'll find someone else to run around with.
No, I'm too scared of them.
You're scared of quite a lot of things. Tattoos, plastic surgery, and the paparazzi. You're in the wrong game.
I go skydiving.
You go skydiving?
Yeah.
Shut up!
I heard you just got your pilot license.
I do. I fly a little plane, yeah. Mm-hmm. I could take you up, pop you out if you want. Do you really skydive?
Yeah, I do.
That is, I think that's admirable. That's unbelievable. When did you start this?
I went for my birthday last year, and then
really?
I like got addicted. It's so much fun.
I heard it's very addictive, but I don't know. I don't know if I could handle it. It's, you know, jumping out of a perfectly good airplane.
Yeah.
Don't they strap you to another a man?
Yeah, you have to.
Well, I might do it for that then.
Sexy.
Is it sexy? It can't be sexy. You really get.
Not really.
They strap you to a big fat guy so you get ballast or something. No, that's good. Weren't you terrified the first time you did it?
Yes, I was, but it's such a rush. It's like, it's an incredible feeling.
Yeah, no, I can imagine. What about your best friend show? Mm-hmm. Do you take any of your best friends, the people that want to be your best friends, take them up, throw them out the plane?
We could try that. I don't know if the network will let us do that.
What network is it?
MTV.
Oh, they'll be fine with it. They've got tea or tequila on that one. They don't give a rat's ass about anything or anybody. What about the best friend show? How many are left?
Well, I have my best friend from the American version, and now we're shooting the British version, which is Paris Hilton's my British best friend. And a couple of them just flew in yesterday.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Now, how can you have more than one best friend?
Because I think everyone can.
Really?
Paris is posse. Mm-hmm.
Posse, she said. I warned you! I'm sorry. Sometimes we get a lot of, you know, a lot of the local homeless people come here for this.
Nice.
Yeah, no, I know. I'm terribly sorry about it. So you're doing a British one. Do you go to Britain and you try and find a friend in Britain?
Mm-hmm.
Well, what have you got then? You fly them in here or you go there?
There's three finalists here right now. I've been in London the past month and I just got back a couple
right.
days ago.
Okay. What do you look for in a best friend?
Someone who's fun, someone I can trust, someone who's not gonna sell me out to the press.
Well, nobody in show business then. Well, you know, it's been just a pleasure to meet you. What a lovely young woman you are, and a yeah. skydiver too. I'm very impressed. And that movie that looks very good.
Thank you.
Yeah, no, I'll go and see it. Well, yeah, I will. All right, I will. Yeah.
Better.
All right, the very lovely Paris Hilton, everybody. We'll be right back. Your stinking vaults round here. And you know why? Because we've got all the electricity we need in the lovely Paris Hilton, everybody. My Lord, Paris, look at you. You look sensational.
Thank you.
Really lovely with your dress and all the other things going on.
I like the blue tie.
Do you like this tie?
Mm-hmm.
It's not mine. I borrowed it from Drew Carey.
Nice.
It looks even thinner on him. How are you doing? Are you all right?
Good. I'm a little jet lagged. Just got back from Tokyo.
Really?
So long trip.
What were you doing in Tokyo?
I was out there for promotional work for my clothing line.
You sell clothing to Japanese people?
Yes.
Do you actually go into the store and help sell it when they come in and they ask in their Japanese way to buy clothes?
Not really. I kind of hang out in the store and say hello to everyone. But
do they know who you are then?
Yeah.
Because I sometimes hang out in stores and say hello to everyone and they're like, who's that creepy guy next to the lady's underwear? That's not right. Or in the lady's underwear sometimes.
Nice.
Now, did you get your new dog? You were telling me you were getting your
new dog.
Did I get
a new dog, yes.
Wait, do you have a photograph?
Yes, that's all right. Baby bear.
Baby
got him
bear.
In Tokyo.
Oh, really? So you smuggled a dog into the country? You can?
No, I did not. I got papers and everything. And
now, this is a Japanese dog?
Mm-hmm.
And does the dog understand English?
I hope so.
All right.
I really hope so.
Do you know, I got a new dog at the weekend, too. I really did.
What kind?
A French bulldog.
Oh, those are so cute.
No, I don't like it at all. What happens is it came to my house. It was a dog that we were going to foster. But, of course, there's no such thing as fostering a dog. And now it's in my house.
That's nice.
No, it's not nice, Paris. It's a small French bulldog. It's very, very farty.
That's not so nice.
Well, I've got a German Shepherd, which I thought was farty, but it's not as farty as the little tiny. Are your dogs farty?
No, not at all.
How many do you have?
5.
Oh, come on. Mm-hmm. They've got to be a bit farty.
No.
Five
they
dogs,
don't
no
do
farts?
That. Not
what do you
my
feed
dogs.
Them?
Steak.
Steak? You feed your little dog steak?
Sometimes.
Right. How often have you done that? Once?
Just know when they want treats, you know, when they're well-behaved.
How do you know when they want treats, then?
Because they'll ask for it.
In Japanese, perhaps?
Sometimes.
All right. Did you have your birthday party? Because remember you said you were going to invite me and then you didn't.
I did invite you.
Oh, you did?
I sent you an email.
Oh, an email. Ah, right. I don't Which email? I didn't
I
get
know.
It. It must have been something wrong with the email system.
I have another one in Las Vegas this weekend.
How many are you having?
I had like 2 in L.A., 2 in New York, just 2 in Japan, and now I'm doing 2 in Las Vegas at the Hard Rock this weekend.
That seems slightly excessive to me.
A little bit. I like to celebrate my birth.
Right, yeah. And how would they differ, the ones in Las Vegas, from the ones in, you know, other towns?
A lot different. The one in L.A., I made everyone wear pink. It was like a whole pink Barbie theme.
That's the one that I was invited to, but didn't get there. Yeah.
Would you have worn pink?
No. Yeah. What's going to happen in Vegas, then?
It's going to be at the Hard Rock Hotel, so we're going to have it at Body English, and it's going to be insane.
Do you ever go to these clubs? I've been to a couple of the clubs, and, you know, and the music, the and people yelling, and the foam, and everything, and I think, this is actually very unpleasant. Do you ever think this is very unpleasant? Don't you think it's quite unpleasant?
Sometimes it is. It depends on where you are, but, you know.
What about the paparazzis? Do they still follow you around all the time?
Yes, yeah. They're outside right now.
Are they really?
Yeah.
You know, you might want to tell them to stay outside. We're having an electrical problem. They don't want to come in and get the... Are you any good with electricity or screwdrivers?
Not really.
What about fixing stuff around the house? Do you ever do that?
No. I'd probably, like, break it more than it was, so...
Where do you live? You live in Hollywood, don't you?
Beverly Hills.
Up in the Beverly Hills, over there somewhere.
Yeah,
I can just
right
see
there.
It out the window. You didn't grow up here, though, did you?
I did grow up here.
Did you really? Mm-hmm. I thought you grew up in New York.
No, I grew up in New York from just high school.
Right.
Until I was 18, then I moved back. But I was born in New York as well. But only
right, so that would put
bit.
You in New York quite a lot of the time then.
No, I moved from 2 years old to 15. I was in L.A., so I feel like an L.A. girl.
And how's the sexiness in your life? How's the dating thing? Are you everything going all right? Because you're all over the papers again. You know that, right?
I'm doing really good.
Oh, good,
I'm really
good,
happy.
Good. Yeah. Is it difficult to find a nice man in L.A.?
It's very difficult.
Yeah, tell me about it, girl. I know.
But if you find someone nice, it's good.
Now, if you meet someone in one of those clubs, how do you know if they're nice? Because you can't really see them and you can't really hear them. They could be...
Yeah. I don't really meet guys at clubs. That's not my type. They're usually, like, the biggest corn cheese balls, so I don't usually talk to guys at clubs.
Then where do you meet them?
Just like
at the laundrette,
friends,
perhaps,
friends, at the gym.
The gym.
I don't know. I'm just making that up.
No, that's.
No, I don't go to the gym.
No, come on, you do. You look very healthy.
Thank you.
I know. Yeah, you know what I mean.
It's all like clothing and dancing.
Yeah, I was gonna say you look healthier than I've seen you look. I think.
Thank you. Just for you.
Really?
No, every time I'm, like, about to do the show, everyone's like, you have to dress really sexy for Craig. He
really?
Likes
who says that?
Just everyone. They're like, he loves cleavage. I was like, okay.
What? Wait, this could be a lie. I enjoy cleavage, and I'm an American citizen. I'm entitled to it.
Who doesn't love cleavage?
You're right. Who doesn't love... I tell you who doesn't love cleavage? Al-Qaeda. They want to take our cleavage ways away from us, but we won't allow it.
Mm-mm.
No. And so your birthday, you're having your last birthday party this weekend?
Yes.
Until next year's 28 birthday parties.
Mm-hmm.
What, how old were you? 20, 23, 24, something like that?
21.
Very mm-hmm. nice. Do you know Liza Minnelli's only 40?
Yes.
Yeah, Liza Minnelli.
You guys do look alike.
I do look like Liza Minnelli.
I know, you put it up and I was like... Wow.
Exactly.
Like some fake eyelashes and you guys could be like twins.
I love you for saying that. Fast Hilton, everybody. We'll be right back. Please welcome the very beautiful, my BFF, Paris Hilton, everybody. Paris Hilton. I love it. You've had your hair done.
Yes.
It's very nice.
Thank you.
It's all kind of zhuzh. Mm-hmm. It's got that post-coital look.
Thank you. It's called Dream Catchers. It's my hair extension line.
Oh, it's not real?
It's real hair, but it's not mine. But you can buy it by Dream Catchers by Paris Hilton.
Well,
if you ever
want to
have some, like, long
hair... I do that occasionally on the show. I put on a wig. But it's not a wig, it's an extension.
No, it's extensions.
What does that mean, then? You attach it to your real hair?
They're easy. Well, All girls do them.
Well, don't they fly off? Or
no.
Can you get... Is there anything else that's attached that's not really yours?
No, I'm all natural.
I was just asking, it's a fair question. How are you? I haven't seen you in a while.
Good, I just got back from Dubai. I was there a month.
Wow, mm-hmm. That was nice. What were you doing over there?
I was shooting my BFF in Dubai.
How many BFFs have you got? I mean,
a lot.
Yeah, my BFF Dubai mm-hmm. for what, Al Jazeera?
It's just girls from all over the Middle East.
Right, and so you find the one that's going to be your best friend in the Middle East? Did you go out clubbing and stuff? It's very clubby in Dubai.
Not so much. I rode camels.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Did they spit on you?
No. It was really fun. It was actually a really sweet camel.
Really? What kind of a camel was it? A new Paris Hilton camel? You can get it at parishiltonscamels.com.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, well, I think it's very entrepreneurial of you to sell hair. I think you might want to sell some camels. People would buy camels from you. They'd buy anything from you. Oh, it's a Paris Hilton camel. People will do it.
I think I'll stick to my hair and other products.
Yeah, yeah. Are you still doing the perfume?
Yes.
Oh, there you go.
I have a new perfume called Siren coming out.
Does it smell like a camel?
No. It smells beautiful.
Does it really?
Mm-hmm.
So Dubai then, you go to Dubai, you meet anyone nice?
I met a new BFF and I met a lot of different people from the royal family and just everyone out there was wonderful. I had a fabulous
Everyone
time.
In Dubai is wonderful?
Yeah, it's actually a very nice place.
Come on, you should check around. They can't all be wonderful.
Everyone who I met was.
All right, fair enough then. Do they have a royal family there?
Yes.
Oh.
The sheikhs and sheikhas. They're cool.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
You had a sheikh in Dubai?
No.
No, all right then. So what about Kathy Griffin there as well? Well, that's... She's very nice. Was she in Dubai with you?
No, I just actually was shooting the show with her here, and that's on next week. And she's
I like
hilarious.
Kathy. She is great, isn't she? I love Kathy.
She's
you know, great. Isaac Mizrahi was here last night, and he said that he didn't say it on the show, but he said that he wanted to give Kathy a makeover. And I said, well, "She looks fine." He said, "No, she needs a little
she
tuning
looks
up
hot right now."
Yeah, hot.
She can rock a bikini.
Did you see her wearing that bikini?
Yes.
It was fantastic. She kept that a surprise.
Mm-hmm.
That was like, where has that been?
Yeah, she's hot.
How are things going with you romantically? Have you any children yet? Do you have any kids?
No, not yet. I'm just too busy with work and traveling.
Well,
so.
You might want to get on that now. You know, have a couple of kids.
I don't
kids.
Have time.
Oh, yeah. No, you'd like it.
One day.
No, you should have some. You have some. Wouldn't you like a couple of little BFFs to run around?
Yes, one day. But yeah. I'm not ready for that right now.
Well, all right. What would you like if you had boys or girls? What are you looking for?
I would rather have a boy first because
really?
Then he could watch after my daughter. you know, like when they're in school, I don't want any guys hitting on my daughter. So the big brother
yeah,
will kind of protect her.
I wouldn't worry about that over much. It's going to happen.
Yeah, but it doesn't happen right away. I mean, you'll be, you know, by the time all that.
No. You'll be all right with it. I look forward to that one day, but we'll see what happens.
Right, okay. You married yet? You got any?
No, not yet.
All right. I probably should have asked that first, really, shouldn't I? You married and then...
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, no, I know. I went to Bahrain when I was in the Middle East. Did you go there? I saw a belly dancer.
I haven't been there yet.
Very, very big woman, belly dancing.
Nice.
I don't even know if she was dancing. I think they just put her out there in the outfit, slapped her, and it started. And then... She's got a very big woman. Very, very attractive.
Sexy.
But, yeah. It was sexy. I think that's sexy. You know.
Did you like it out there?
I did like it out there. I liked the
was
heat.
Was it hot?
It was hot, but yeah. Not in the Paris Hilton hot.
Yeah. Dubai was like 115 to 120 degrees sometimes.
Did you just walk around and go, oh, it's so hot?
Yes. Not in a good way.
Now, why were you doing my BFF? Is that for MTV in the Middle East?
No, it's a different network.
What is
it? We did it in London as well, so they're all different networks.
And do you think that, did any terrorists try and infiltrate the BFF cast?
No.
Was there any, like, very tall, lanky, bearded BFF?
No.
Oh, I really want to be your friend, Paris. Was there any of that?
No, it's like such a stereotype. I think a lot of people who haven't been there think it's all like that, but it's actually different.
No, I know.
It's really safe.
It is safe. And mm-hmm. Dubai's nice, and Bahrain is nice, and where else have I been out there? That's about it. you know what you should do? You should go out on a USO tour. And go to the places that are not so nice. They'd love to see you, you know.
I'm going to.
Are you really? Mm-hmm. Oh, that's fantastic. When?
I'm not sure yet. We're putting it in my schedule. But
I don't know. I'm probably going out around about Thanksgiving. You want to come with me?
Sure.
We'll go to Afghanistan.
Okay.
You're my BFF Tora Bora. That'd be fun, wouldn't it?
Crazy.
All right, well, Paris, it's always lovely to see you. You look adorable with your hair as well.
Thank you.
Very, very nice. Paris Hilton, everybody. We're right back. Before Christmas show. Wait, what? You all right? Yeah, you were just shushing the audience? Sure. Whoa. What a warm-up man. He gets the audience to be quiet. He cools them down. My first guest tonight is a friend of the show. She's a friend of mine. She's adorable. She's got a new hair and beauty line. Please welcome the American treasure that is Paris Hilton, everybody. Paris. It is always a delight to see you. You look very well.
Thank you.
You look very... You're beautiful. Your hair looks lovely. And other areas of you look just spectacular.
Thank you.
Have you been working out in some way? You look very buff.
I'm doing a little Pilates.
Yeah, mm-hmm. It's working.
Thank you.
Yeah. I'm having to do the guy thing to do that with my eyes because I keep... See, when guys do that, they're not being rude. They're trying to be polite and not look at your boobies. Does that happen to you a lot?
Sometimes.
Yeah, but... How are things? How have you been?
Great. It's been really working and getting ready for the holidays.
Really? Are you excited about Christmas?
I love Christmas.
Do you have a big family Christmas at home?
Yeah, every year. It's a huge tradition. We're always together. We do cooking and open presents.
What kind of cooking do you have? California Christmas?
No, kind of like... No, we definitely have carbs, definitely have meat.
Yeah.
Kind of like Thanksgiving, like the turkey.
That's
the
problem I have. Thanksgiving dinner, Christmas dinner, how do you make them different?
I like the same food for that time because it's family-like.
I can't eat two meals the same in any given year. That drives me crazy.
I like it.
Does it make you sleepy if you eat turkey?
Mm-hmm.
What about quaaludes? They make you sleepy?
I haven't tried that.
Yeah. They used to make me terribly sleepy, much sleepier than turkey. See when people say, oh, this turkey's making me sleepy? I'm like, you should try quaaludes. They knock you up. How things been? Have you got a fragrance out now? Are you wearing it now? May I smell you?
Yes.
All right. I'm just coming in to smell. Hold on. Well, what a love.
Siren.
Siren, mm-hmm. It's called. Like a police siren? Like in Cops?
No, like right. Mermaids back in the day. Like
oh, yes. Goddesses. The legend of Ulysses, I believe it was, wasn't it? Who he would hear the sirens and he would want. Sailors would try and get to the sirens, but they couldn't get to this. But they went close to them and then they hurt their rocks or something. Something happened.
Yeah.
Is that what it is? Is to entice men to be dashed on the rocks before you?
Just kind of like be sexy and like right. A goddess.
How do you actually get involved in the making of a perfume? Do you go, oh, put some more turkey smell in there or something like that?
I am involved with everything I do.
Really?
In my new hair product line, the Celebrity Styler, which I use tonight.
Your hair looks amazing. Very celebrity styled. It's what is that? Is it a mousse?
No, it's actually a product which can curl your hair and straighten it, so it's like a flat iron and curling iron in one.
Oh, right, yeah. Mm-hmm. Have you ever seen a mousse close up, like a mousse?
No.
Actually, I think they're quite adorable and funny-looking things, right? A mousse? But they're dangerous. Did you know that?
I haven't heard that.
Yeah, I saw it on Mythbusters. Do you watch Mythbusters?
Mm-mm. I haven't seen that. I just got a pet pig, though. And
you did
adorable.
Not? Mm-hmm. What kind of pig? Giant?
No, she's like this big. Her name's Princess Pigolette. She's a little tiny teacup.
A teacup pig?
Mm-hmm.
Do they make such a thing?
Now they do.
I guess. What do they taste like, these kind of pigs?
I would never eat that.
You wouldn't? Oh, it's not for eating. It's
no,
for a pet.
It's a pet, yeah. She's so cute.
I'm so sorry. I thought you were, you know, farming.
No.
They start a farm with small animals and build up to larger ones.
I basically do have a farm, though.
Yeah?
I got a new parrot, too, an African gray, and they live, like, almost 100 years.
Well, how old's the parrot you got?
He's 4 months old.
Well, you're going to break his heart, because, you know, I mean, I think you'll live a long time, but the parrot may outlive you.
I know. I should put him in my will.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's going to be great, that. You would, as an old lady, you shuffle off this mortal coil and then, I left all the money to the parrot! You should teach the parrot to say very rude things. Have you done that? You have? I adore you. What did you teach it to say? Like a small town in Montana? That kind of thing?
I don't know. Some words that I can't say on television.
Oh.
I think it's funny when parrots do that.
I like parrots that cuss.
Mm-hmm.
If your parrot doesn't cuss, go and join Al-Qaeda. That's what I think.
Show one day.
You can bring the parrot on. Mm-hmm. Parrots that cuss are welcome here. although I'm not big on birds. I'm not crazy about birds. Flappy, feathery. They remind me of kind of angry midget transvestites.
No, mine doesn't look like that. His name's Hank. He's hot.
Hank?
Hank.
Oh, that's a nice name. What's the name of your pig, Princess Pigolette?
Princess Pigolette.
Is she a princess?
She's treated like one.
Really, what do you do to treat a pig? You'll give it its own crap to roll around in?
No. Treated like part of the family. She sleeps in bed with me.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
How many other animals have you got in the bed with you?
Six dogs.
You got six dogs and a kitten.
And I have two bunnies and two frogs, but they don't stay in bed with me.
Yeah, you want to keep the amphibians and the rodents out.
Yeah.
So if anybody's trying to get through all these animals to get to you, they're going to be pretty tired when they get past all that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is that the idea? In some way to remain chaste by surrounding yourself by adorable creatures.
I just love animals.
No, I love animals too. I do. I really do. Are you a vegetarian?
I eat fish and I eat chicken sometimes, but I don't eat red meat.
Yeah. Chicken are birds, Paris. And Hank's a bird.
Maybe I'll stop eating that.
Yeah. The trouble with chicken, though, delicious. Parrot's not delicious. At least I don't think so. I've never eaten one. If you bring Hank here, I might change my mind. I'd never eat your bird. And I don't mean anything by that. Yeah. Because, never mind. No. Oh, boy. Got myself in a bit of hot water there. What else is going on? Have you been to Las Vegas recently?
Yeah, I was just there last month.
What'd you do?
I was there for a big party and just
now,
had
when
fun.
You go to these parties, do you have a nice time or is it really just work? Like you have to just walk around and be Paris Hilton?
It's both. I love to gamble and when I'm hosting events, I'll just go and say hi to everyone and
is that what you
dance.
Have to do? Just dance? Yeah, are you a big dancer?
I like to for a little bit.
Do you watch the show You Think You Can Dance and all these shows?
Mm-hmm.
Would you ever do the, what's that, Dance Your Celebrity or what's it called?
Dancing with the Stars.
Yeah, Dancing with the Stars. Yeah, would you ever do that?
They've asked me, but no.
Why not? You'd be great at it.
I don't know.
You could wear that dress.
Thank you. I don't know. I wouldn't want to do that show.
No, you can wear that dress anywhere you like, to be honest. But the, that's one of the great things about being in America, really, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Actually, one of the great things about being in America is I can wear that dress anywhere I like.
Yeah, I'll let you borrow it.
I'm not. It's a lot of Pilates before I'm getting into that thing. Well, we're out of time again.
Aww.
Yeah, no. I like to end on an awkward pause these days. You wanna? Good shoes, though. I like your shoes, too.
Thank you.
Is that pink on the inside there, on the inside of the heel there?
Yes.
Oh, see, that's class.
You're sexy.
It is sexy. It's these little touches. I think you're getting sexier, to be honest. Can I say that?
Yeah.
Yeah,
so
I think
are you.
You are. You're getting more kind of. You know, it's getting kind of a little more. Because you used to go for willowy. Willowy used to be your thing, kind of. But now it's a bit more. Like that. I like it. I think it works for you.
Thank you.
I like that pushing together thing you're doing as well.
Yeah.
You know, the trouble is, I've now reached the point where I can actually do that too. Which is
that's hot.
It is. Yeah, women are very attracted to that person. It's always lovely to see you. The delightful Paris Hilton, everybody. My next guest is a very beautiful, lovely girl, and I like her. Please welcome Paris Hilton, everybody. Paris Hilton. Dear.
I'm great.
You do. You look sensational.
I just got back from vacation.
You did? Mm-hmm. Where were you on vacation?
I was everywhere. I went to South Africa for the World Cup.
Nice.
Safari.
Do you play soccer?
No, but I enjoy watching it.
Really? Is your voice all right? It sounds quite husky.
Thank you.
Oh.
You know, I've been flying a lot. I was there. I was in Saint-Tropez and Monaco and Ibiza.
God, that sounds like hell. How did you manage? What happens in these fabulous places? You just walk up and down a bit and everyone goes, ooh, and then you go home, is that it?
No, I go on a vacation like anyone else.
What, you lie on the beach and read a book and stuff?
Go swimming, lie on the beach, jet skiing.
Listen, you didn't get an email from me today by any chance.
Do you have the iPhone 4?
Yeah.
It doesn't work.
No,
I bought it for Africa. I'm so excited. The commercial, it's like you could see a screen and watch. It doesn't even make calls.
Work. Yeah, it doesn't work. And what it did do is it sent out all my things that should never be seen.
Oh, brutal.
Yeah, brutal is the word I use. I went, oh, this is brutal.
Yeah.
And the only reason I knew is because he sent me an email this morning saying, okay, well, let's talk about that.
Oh, no. It happens.
Yeah, I guess.
I'll flip that phone.
I'm looking for new friends. What about your show when you make new friends by having a show? I could do that. How do you do it? You have like American Idol or something?
It's just basically hanging out with people and having fun and kind of doing silly things. It's, you know, it's television and it's supposed to be funny, so we do silly tasks and make
television's supposed to be funny?
Yeah. You know that better than anyone.
No, I'm in trouble. Hey, can I see that? Where's that? Can I see that? That's a bit splendid. Look at this.
Thank you.
Look at that. Did you get that when you were in Africa?
No, actually in Monaco.
Oh, yeah, because I was going to say.
It's the Cartier Panther.
It's the Cartier Panther?
Mm-hmm.
I used to dance under that name. When you go to, like, all these fancy places and do all that fancy stuff, when you were in Africa, did you go, like, what people do when they go, did you go on a safari and all
that?
Yeah,
of course.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, it was incredible. We saw every single animal, the whole Big Five, and it was just...
The Big Five?
Yeah, all the cheetah.
All right, cheetah, elephant.
Yes.
Lion.
Keep going.
Regis. cheetah, elephant, lion, hippo?
Yep.
Hippo's a big animal. They're dangerous hippos, you know. You can get killed by it. More people die of hippo attacks than shark attacks. Did you know that?
I did not know that.
I made it up, but it might be true. But I don't think they'll do hippo week. Did you see my shark week thing? I did shark week.
I heard about it.
All right, thanks.
I TiVo'd it, so
yeah, all
I'll
right,
check
yeah.
it out tonight.
No, that's great. Thanks.
I will. I feel bad.
No, it's okay. You were busy. You couldn't watch it.
Yeah, next time we see, I promise I'll watch it.
No, okay. No, it's good. So you saw the big five then. Wait, did I get them all? The hippo,
yes.
Jaguar, leopard, Regis, and tiger? Oh, I can't remember. What was it? What are the five? Lion, elephant.
Giraffe.
Giraffe's the one I didn't have. Ooh. Yeah. I like giraffes. Did you see giraffes eating?
Yeah, and they had little babies. It was amazing. I got to play with little lions.
How do babies eat? Do they go for small trees?
No, they're really actually very tall as well.
So they're born tall, eh?
Mm-hmm.
And you saw baby what? Baby giraffes and baby lions?
Baby cheetahs.
Baby cheetahs.
Baby lions, baby cubs. I got to feed them like up in a bottle.
Really?
So sweet. It was amazing.
Yeah, but they'll move very quickly. That's the thing about cheetahs. The fastest animal on earth, apparently.
Yeah.
I look forward to your letters. And you can expect an email in return. What else did you do? You went to Africa and then you went to Monaco?
Then, yeah, we went to Monaco.
What did
then...
you do in Monaco? What's Monaco like?
Just go to, you know, have a beautiful lunch, go shopping, go jet skiing, then go
jet
to
skiing.
Jimmy's night.
Jimmy's? What's that? Is that a nightclub?
Yeah.
The fabulous people go there?
It's pretty fabulous.
Do you think any of these people would have seen my Shark Week special? Like, if I was to go there, people are like, hey, look who it is. It's Mr. Shark Week guy. Come on, let's dance.
Totally. Maybe all over you.
Do you dance when you go to nightclubs?
Yeah.
Really?
Who doesn't?
Well, I don't. I get embarrassed when I dance. I always feel like I look such a fool. I do.
You're a little dancing queen, and you know it.
Well.
Sure. I've seen him at the club.
Oh, come now. You've never seen me at a club. I'm the guy outside going, I know Paris Hilton. I'm with Paris.
Sorry about
that. Does everybody pretend to know you at these nightclubs so they can get in?
I've heard a lot of crazy stories. People pretending to be my brothers, my cousins, and getting like free things and pretending to be me even. There's one girl who dresses up as me. She wears sunglasses. It kind of looks like me, but if she takes them off, she looks nothing like me.
It's me.
I knew that.
No. I actually do the same thing with Liza Minnelli. I just walk around like
I
this and
that.
People go, Liza Minnelli, and I go, yes. Thank you, everyone.
I'd love to see that.
What's that? What do you smell of?
Teas.
Teas?
It's my new fragrance.
Oh.
My tenth fragrance.
Do you just excrete a new fragrance every time you want?
Well, it's actually one of the top sellers right now, so it's very exciting.
But how do you just smell it out of fabulous?
Something I just mix up in my travels. And
you have a
world.
Laboratory?
Yeah. Well, not at my house. It's,
you should have it in your house. Maybe in the basement or in a turret somewhere. You could say, I don't want to be disturbed. I'm going to my laboratory. And then mix potions and stuff. Do you create the smell?
I actually create
smells, but nobody wants them.
I actually do.
You actually stir them up and stuff?
I have my 11th one coming out in December.
Right.
It's amazing. So
and what it's called Teas?
The new one is Teas, yeah.
Right.
And it's like really an homage to Marilyn Monroe because she's like my idol and I love her. So
really?
The whole picture is me as her and we just, it's really cool.
Did you ever, is there any reported smellings of what she smelled like?
Beautiful.
Oh, I'm sure. She smelled lovely. Did you ever read that book or see the movie Perfume?
No.
Oh, it's pretty good. Yeah, it's about a serial killer who. It's about a serial killer who has a really advanced sense of smell, and he's trying to create the perfect fragrance. It's set just before the revolution in France, I think, isn't it? Written by Patrick Susskind, a German writer, and you'd like it actually. I'm not kidding.
Sounds kind of lame.
No, it's not lame. It's not lame.
It's not my type of movie.
No, you'd like it. I'm serious. I'll send you a copy, and I'll sign it Patrick Susskind. I don't know him, but I'll write it in. Because who's seen
I'll
a signature?
Sell it on eBay.
Sell it on eBay. Yeah, say, autographed copy of the book. But it's, you'd like it. It's actually very good.
Okay.
And he uses perfume to create havoc, and then guys go nuts.
Perfume kind of does that, too.
Really?
In a good way.
Yes.
Every girl who wears it, they say, I have so many guys coming up and hitting on me, like, what, you smell so good. Because it has pheromones in the perfume. So.
No, I get it. It's the only thing is, I am a guy. I know, contrary to, and I. Although we do operate somewhat on smell, we're kind of visual. You know, it's boobies really. But yeah, I suppose you can douse your boobies in teas.
You can do whatever you want with it, yeah.
Too hot.
Oh, yeah, you met Jeff?
Hi, Jeff.
Yeah. Yes.
He's nice. He actually, at the weekend, he puts on sunglasses and going around in a wig and pretends to get in a nightclub pretending to be you. He doesn't look like you.
He looks like someone I know.
What? He does look like someone you know
him? The hair. I don't want to say. That's mean. Sorry, dude. But the hairdo.
The hairdo?
Yeah.
He's got metal hair.
I just think
hair.
That's so over when guys have, like, that moment.
I try to tell him
know,
that, but, you know.
Sometimes it looks good, but...
No, it's...
Is sex a possibility?
Nobody. You're not my type.
I don't know, man. Apparently his genitals are only days away. Yeah. They got stuck in customs when he was getting transported in, so he's got a penis, it just hasn't arrived yet.
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm gonna heave.
You're gonna heave?
I'm kidding.
Do it, do it. It'll make YouTube.
I'm joking.
No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
It's a figure of speech, darling.
No, I know. Really? What, I'm gonna heave?
Honey. Come on.
You got my email today, didn't you? You've been very fractious with me the whole time you've been here. All right. Well, listen, it's lovely to see you again. I'm glad you're doing well, and your hair's lovely, and you smell teasy.
Thank you.
You actually do smell a bit teasy.
Thank you.
All right. Well, we're done. You want to throw it at the commercials? I always have to do it.
Yeah.
Okay, go.
Bye.
That's no damn good. Bye. Oh, you have to do. We'll be right back after these messages. Enjoy the products advertised. All that kind of.
There or here.
Whatever. What's that was the only one that works. Are you ready?
Ready.
I'll give you the countdown then. Right.
Yeah.
All right then. 5, 4, 3, 2.
We'll see you after the commercials. Bye, sexy.
Wait, so that's two? That's two, right? I said Oxygen was Oprah's channel, but it's not, is it? It's just, no. Oh, no, I'm in trouble now. Please welcome the adorable and sophisticated Paris Hilton, everybody. Paris Hilton.
Thank
you. You look really nice. You know what, the look you've got going on? It's a little reminiscent of a sort of 1960s, 60s air hostess.
Thank you.
That's what I...
Wasn't really what I was going for.
Really? No, I think that's a good... What were you going for then?
It reminds me of like Judy Jetson from the Jetsons somehow. It was like really modern looking.
Yeah, no, that's good. Are these your shoulders?
Yeah, I've been working out a lot.
Have you been doing Pilates?
Yeah.
Yeah. That you get these Madonna arms if you do that. Listen, I saw this on the cover of Variety, which is like a blog but in paper form. They have you on the cover there with the... What is it you've done? You're the billion-dollar entrepreneur? Congratulations.
Thank you.
What does that mean?
I got honored as the billion-dollar entrepreneur.
I see, yes. I see now. I feel like such a fool. It was right there in front of me the whole time.
Yeah, it was a huge honor. I'm really proud.
What do you do? Is that because you sell the perfume and then the
17 product lines.
17?
Mm-hmm.
So what are they then? Perfume?
Perfume, shoes, handbags,
cheese,
clothes.
Cheese? No. No cheese?
Eyelashes, dog clothes.
Eyelashes?
Uh-huh. Oh. Makeup, sunglasses.
How much is it for eyelashes?
They're like $10.
A lash or for the full rack?
A full lash.
So you get like $10 and you put them on?
Mm-hmm.
Do people are wearing a lot of eyelashes now? I think I've got very stubby.
I'm wearing them.
I thought they were real.
I can get some for you.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Can look like Liza Minnelli.
Oh, I do look like Liza Minnelli. That's right. That's right. You weep into your tea, bitch. I look like Liza Minnelli. But this is good. This is very good. And does this mean that you're very wealthy then?
I do well for myself.
Do you? Selling? Do you ever go to the stores and help sell the perfume?
No, I do like appearances there, but I don't actually work.
Well, that's all right. I mean, but could you ever, like, if someone came in and said, oh, I want, what's the name of your perfume?
There's 13 different ones, so.
Really?
Yes.
All different smells?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know obviously. There were 13 different smells. Yeah. I thought it was like food and poo, and that's about it.
No, they're different.
Really? So, and do you construct these smells?
Mm-hmm.
Really? Do you have a very sensitive nose?
Yes.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
What? And do you go to a factory and then put... Do you have a laboratory in your house?
Well, I've been doing this for 10 years now, so
right.
It's been a while.
So that you go, you make the perfumes yourself using science?
Basically.
So, all right, so talk me through the perfume process then. You start with a beaker of water.
They basically send me all different types of fragrances. And,
I like it, I don't like it, this needs a little more cinnamon.
It's a process.
Right, okay, well that's nice. What about the shoes?
I'm actually wearing the shoes right now. Oh. I designed these.
Oh, these are, now that's got a red sole, that's a bit like Christian Louboutin.
They're pink.
Oh, they're pink, oh sorry.
Yeah.
Do you know, I met him when I was in Paris, which is coincidentally named after you.
I met him too, I
liked him very much.
He makes
the shoes. He had these shoes that had eyes on them.
He's pretty talented.
He's very talented. But I think that if you have shoes that... wouldn't you worry if you were wearing shoes with eyes on them that they were looking up your skirt?
I never thought about it.
Well, you've got to think about these things. Right. You're in the public eye. You're the billion-dollar entrepreneur thing. Now, listen, tell me about your show then. Do you give these people full access?
Yes. There is complete full access.
Really?
And we show everything.
Is that a good idea? I mean, you know, you got to leave a certain air of mystery. You know, you're a sophisticated woman. You've got to, you know, leave some bits covered up.
No, it is. But I mean, personal things that happen in my life, it's all on the show.
It really is?
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Like that, was that a poo doctor you were talking to in that clip?
No, that was an acupuncturist.
An acupuncturist?
Mm-hmm. For stress.
Do you have stress?
Who doesn't?
Well, you know, you're holding it in your shoulders.
I know.
Yeah.
Idiot.
Do you ever get massages?
Yeah.
I like a massage. But see, when you get a massage, do you ask for a male massage or you don't stress? It doesn't matter.
Only female. I get uncomfortable with the guy.
I'm like that too. Only female. No, seriously, I think because, you know, if it's a dude, I know men, and we're not, you know, we're dirty.
He's going to want you too much.
He's going to want, you know, he's going to get a glimpse of, you know, the old Liza Minnelli's.
Sexy.
And he's going to go, and his professional courtesy will go out the window and he'll go nuts. Yeah.
I can see that happening.
Yeah. No, but do you ever wonder, when you're getting the massage, do you think, I don't know this person, and then they could sell stories about my body to TMZ and stuff?
No, I only have one person I've used for years.
Like, oh, you do?
Yeah, I don't use random people.
All right.
No.
You should. What if you're like you're touring, right? And you're going around the world with your perfumes and your shoes and your eyelashes, and you're in a hotel and you think, oh, I'm so stressed, my shoulders are out to here.
Well, I'm never wearing a dress like this on your show again.
It's nice. So anyway, like you're going around with your perfume and your eyelashes and your shoes. You're in a hotel. You're feeling stressful. You wouldn't get a massage from a regular hotel massage.
No, I would.
Yeah. Would you ever knock on the next door and say, hi, I'm Paris Hilton. Sorry to bother you. Could you give me a massage?
No. Not
you should
thing.
Do that. That'd get you in the paper, all right.
That would be creepy.
Do you ever get bored being in the? Do you ever get bored and think, oh, see, I can't take this famous thing anymore?
Oh, I've been doing this for 15 years now.
Yeah, I know. I've been doing this for 6 years. I'm bored off my ass right now. I mean,
I never get bored.
You really don't?
No. You only live once, so you have to make the most of it.
I don't know. There are many Hindus that would disagree with you.
What?
Do you believe that you only live once?
I think you do.
Yeah. I don't know. I mean, I like to think I'd like to come back as an animal. Shark, actually. Would you like to come back as an... Do you still have pets? You have lovely pets.
Yes, I do.
What do you have?
I just got a new sugar glider, which is like a flying squirrel.
Wow.
So cute.
That's interesting. What does it do?
Flies.
Nice. And does it store its nuts for the winter?
No.
It doesn't?
No.
It just goes, oh, I see some nuts and it flies over there and gets them. A flying squirrel, they're kind of like monkeys a little bit, aren't they?
It's a little bit. It's a marsupial, so it kind of right. looks like a monkey squirrel.
Australians know all about that. Kangaroo.
I
like Australia. Where have you been to in Australia?
Sydney and Melbourne. I lived in the Gold Coast for 3 months.
Did you?
Mm-hmm.
What did you do there?
I was shooting a movie called House of Wax.
So I've seen that movie.
Scary.
Yeah. No, it's good.
Thanks.
Better than some I'm in anyway, I tell you that.
Huge.
That isn't saying much, though. Yeah.
Sexy.
Hey, mouth organ or awkward pause? We're out of time.
What?
Mouth organ. Or awkward pause.
What's a mouth organ?
Well, mouth organ is like, we have this thing, because we don't have a band and we only get the robot. Oh, say hi to Jeff, will you? He's a big fan.
Hi, Jeff.
Hey.
All right.
What up?
So, what we do is, because we don't have a band, right, we like to end the show with, you know, little segments with the guests by either saying mouth organ, awkward pause. Mouth organ is a harmonica where you uh-huh. play the harmonica. Awkward pause is we do an awkward pause. Or touch my glittery ball, which is a new segment we're thinking about, but we haven't really figured it out yet.
Mouth organ?
All right, then. Here's what you do. You just take it out. Can you play?
No.
Really? You surprise me.
Do I look like I know how to play this?
Yeah, you just take it out. Take it out and, you know, blow it. You ready? Yeah, let me see you do that again.
Bring my lipstick.
Yeah, no, sure. All right. Wait. That looks good. Ready? One, two, three, four. Brass Hilton, everybody. Some harmonica.
Sweet. And will you drum? You can drum.
I'll drum. Well,
ooh, I like drumming. Here, do you like that? We both have drums, given the thing. Do you like, can you do this? You know, Mike Longo taught Benny Wallace this thing from Dizzy Gillespie. Here it is. Wait, listen to it. It's, well, what are you doing? Wait a minute. I'm D. It goes like this. Now, listen. Now, watch. Now watch.